Hi everyone, this is Piyush Jain. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will talk about the Tableau data connectors. So I will open the Tableau first. So when we open the Tableau desktop, the UI would look like this. This is divided basically into three parts. In the first section, we can see the different data connectors that Tableau offers. And in the second one, we can see the last modified sheet or workbook that we have opened. And in the third section, we can see the training and all. If you wanted to see some training that Tableau offers, so we can directly click on this link. Let's understand the connectors first. So whenever you have to create any report, so we need data. And data can be available into your Excel file, database, or any data warehouse. So you have to load the data from your source to the Tableau. Then we can start to create our reports and dashboards. So Tableau directly offers 50 plus data connectors through which we can directly connect and load the data. Let's understand how we can connect or load the data from Excel file. So here we have direct option to select the Excel file. I will click on this and we have to select the Excel. So I will select a global superstore here. And now this window is opened. And here we can see we have three sheets available into global superstore. One is orders, people, and returns. I will drag the orders. So we have to basically create a report on order data. So I will drag the order sheet. And here we can see whatever the number of columns available into the order sheet, you will see all the columns is coming. And now we can go to the sheet one. So whatever is column is coming from data source, in the below section in the data pane, we can see all the columns. Now let's understand how we can connect to Oracle. I will again click on data, new data source, and I will select the Oracle. So when we connect to any RDBMS, so we have to put the server details through which it will connect. So I have installed the Oracle in my machine. So this is the server name of my database. And we have to mention the username and password. So the password, I will type it here, and then we can click on the sign in. Once we click on the sign in, we will see this window will open. Here we can see the connection details. And now from database, if you have to load the data from particular table, so we have to select First, we have to select the schema under which schema the table is available. So let's say I will select pgen. So here we can see the different schema that is available into this Oracle database. We have to select the appropriate schema first. Then we have to select the tables. So now we have two ways to load to connect to the table. First one, we can directly drag the table. So I have just dragged the demo orders, and whatever column is available into this table, we can see all the columns. Instead of that, I will just remove it. And second way, we can drag this new custom SQL option. Here we have the option to write the queries as well. So I will type select stuff from demo customers. Okay. And so instead of demo customer, I will type the demo orders. So here I have connected to demo orders table, and we can see the same columns is coming. So there is two ways to connect. Either you can drag directly table name, but if you connect to the custom query, here we have option to apply the filters or any condition or joins if you write any complex query at all. That we can do it in this section. Now we can update it so we can see the data, whatever is coming. Now let's go to the sheet one. So right now we have two data sources. One is Global Superstore, second is Oracle. Now we'll connect to the SQL Server also. I will again go to data, new data source, and I will select the SQL Server. Now it will again same kind of pop-up window will open. Here we have to mention the server name and database, and I have configured with the window authentication, so it won't ask to mention the username and password. But if your database is configured by username and password, then you have to select this option and you have to type the username and password. But in my case, I have configured as window authentication, so I will just click on the sign in. And here you can see the window is quite similar as we seen when we connect to the Oracle. Instead of schema, here we have to select the database name. So I will select master. And whatever tables available into this database, we can see the list of tables. Again, we have two options. Either we can select the table directly, or we can write the query as well. So we have this new custom SQL option. And here we can write the query. Okay, so here you can see the data. If whatever is available, we can see that data. I hope you like this video.